Assalamu alaikum class. Welcome to my CV workshop. Just gonna do the register now. Nice of all of you guys to attend. Ashraf?
Yes, sir.
That's the end of the register. Can we quiet it down, please? Fingers on lips, everybody. Fingers on lips. Welcome to the news at 5:35.
What?
Today's headlines.
Why 5:35?
Because no one else does that at 5:35. Headline number one, CV goes totally wrong. Whee!
No, but really, it goes terribly wrong. And it's your CV, so it's not a joke. Can we be serious about this?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Don't write too much.
Where is this guy, man? I'm sure he said today.
Assalamu alaikum. It's done.
Finally done, yeah?
It's complete.
It's been about a month.
Don't worry, bro.
Yeah?
It's worth the wait.
Okay.
Here it is.
What's this, man?
My CV.
Have you written a story?
Curriculum vitae.
Have you written a story? It starts with once upon a time. What the? What's this? When you're doing your CV, it doesn't really need to be more than 2 pages. I've seen CVs that are 3, 4, 5, 6 pages long. And actually, if you put a CV in front of me and it's more than 2 pages long and the experience required for that role doesn't need to be extensive, then I'm not going to read your CV. So make sure your CV is not more than 2 pages long. And if it's on 2 pages and you can do it back to front, then do it back to front. It would make me want to read it even more.
Don't download someone else's.
It says here your name is Laura Wong.
Laura Wong.
But that's not you. Where did you get this from?
Bro, I got online. Don't worry about it, bro.
But it's not you.
Doesn't matter.
And it says you can do ballet. Have you learned ballet since I last saw you?
Can learn. How hard can it be?
Yeah, but it's not you.
Bro, what is this?
You need to do it again.
You're getting that back.
No, I'm not getting it back. Don't go copying your friend's CV. Don't go downloading CVs from online. Be sure that actually when you do go to the interview, they will question you on stuff that you've put in your CV. And if you can't explain half the stuff, then actually they know that you haven't put that time and effort in. It's your one opportunity without you physically being there to present yourself. Present yourself in the best way possible to highlight all the fantastic skills that you've got in order for you to do that job. There's lots of fantastic websites that you can go on to check templates and everything like that, but just make sure it's your CV and it's got your name on it.
Don't waffle. Talk sense.
You okay, yeah? You okay, yeah?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Okay, let's have a look through your CV then, yeah? So, your hobbies, good thing to start with, Deep sea diving, that must be fun, yeah, exciting, yeah, definitely. Parachuting, yep. You do a lot of stuff. Monster trucks, football, traveling
again.
Sightseeing.
No, that was traveling.
Taking a shower.
Yeah, I like
taking
that.
A shower. It's okay. Fine. Breathing.
You got to do the old breathing, bro.
Walking.
Yeah, obviously.
Where's your education and your career history?
What?
There it is. I see it now. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's not gonna work out.
Huh?
Whenever you're doing your CV, make sure the most relevant stuff is at the top. If you're looking to get into work and you have lots of work experience, make sure all the relevant stuff is at the top. So you're gonna put your personal profile first, yes, fantastic, but make sure your work experience is underneath that. If you're just graduated and actually you haven't got that work experience, then make sure your graduation stuff and the courses that you've done is just under your personal statement. Don't go into hobbies and skills and everything like that. You need the most relevant stuff at the top. If an employer looks at your CV and only reads the first half of it, are they going to get what you're trying to put across and what job that you're trying to apply for?
Back up what you say.
Where is this fantastic personal statement you've been bragging about? Yeah, the best statements ever written, yeah? Yeah, I'm hoping, yeah, that's it, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
You're joking, right? What does this say?
I'm the best.
What do you mean yes! You're the best? What do you mean you're the best? You can't have this as a personal statement. It's not.
But it's true.
What do you mean it's true? You can't put this in your CV.
Why not?
Because
it's a personal statement.
No, it's not a personal
Personally,
statement.
I think I'm the
no.
best.
Don't be so stupid.
What?
Don't be so
it's quite
stupid.
Harsh.
Whenever you write in your personal statement, make sure it's always personal towards you and specific to the role that you're applying for. If you're saying things like you're fantastic at time management, give me examples. I want to see examples of when you've done fantastic time management. If you're telling me you're the best, give me examples. What are you the best at? Be specific when you're writing it. And actually, that's going to be the first and opening statement of your CV and the first thing that your employer reads. So if it doesn't catch them, no matter how much extensive experience and education and everything you got to work within that role, they're not going to read the rest of it. Make sure your personal statement is always short, snappy, straight to the point, and highlights the right skills in order for you to do that specific job.
Have a clear structure.
You worked in Harrods. When did you work in Harrods? Let me
say it.
It's why is it? Yeah, good, fantastic. You worked in 2006 to 2000. Where's the?
Stand up.
What do you mean stand up?
It's here, bro.
2000. Okay, yeah. And then where's the rest of it?
There's one here.
Okay, and the other part to this is where?
In your laptop, bro.
That's a picture of a rhino. why are you giving me a picture of a rhino?
Why not?
How's this gonna help?
How will it not help? It's me with the rhino.
Are you wasting my time?
It's me and a rhino.
What are you talking about?
Have you ever been with a rhino?
Whenever you're doing your CV, make sure it has proper structure to it, because actually that's a reflection on you. If you can't organize your CV and have some real structure, how are you going to organize yourself within the workplace and put any sort of structure into your life and organizing the things that you need to do at work? Make sure it's synced. So if you have your personal statement, then you have the most relevant stuff after. If you're looking to get into work, I want to see your employment history after your personal statement. Then you can go down to your education and leave your hobbies and stuff like that for last. That's not even a necessity. You don't need to put that in. But if you want to highlight that there's some great stuff that you do in your spare time that is related and relevant to the job that you're applying for, then of course put that in. But make sure it has structure and make sure it looks good. When I'm looking at it, it wants to be appealing. So first thing that you're going to please is the eyes, and then they're going to read it. If it doesn't look good and it's not structured, they might not even pick it up off the desk. It might go straight in the bin.
Smile to Jannah. I am very passionate about the ballet. I'm gonna pull you out. You're too angry.
Go. No, I'm not getting it back.
Good.
Go. No. Go and do it again. Go and do it again.
Then you're not gonna put down the best.
What does that say?
I'm the best.
You're the. What do you mean? You're the. This is not. Just go. I'm sure I got stuff to do. Just, are you still here? No, just.
It's just too good for you, bro.
Just go.
Hi, welcome to the news at 5:35.
5:35?
Yes, because no one else does it at 5:35. Headlines, go! Those are the headlines for today.
That's it. That's all we have for you today.
It's all right to be impressed.
No, it's not good. Where are you going? We need to talk about this. This is not acceptable.
To get another this picture not... of the rhino.
No more pictures of the rhino. No more pictures of the...
Like, comment and subscribe. Oh, too smart to jungle.